It's the Apple Music Awards, and I'm joined by our 2021 Artist of the Year Africa, Wizkid. Wiz, what a year it has been.
Yeah, man.
What a year it has been. Made in Lagos, just continues to grow and grow. Bagged a Grammy, smashed the Billboard charts. Mm-hmm. What is that like? Because your biggest year seems to have come more than 10 years into your career.
I know.
So how do you reflect on the past 12 months?
It's just a blessing, you know, like being able to be here for that amount of years and still doing what I do, and the people still like my music, like, and my music makes them feel something, like that's amazing to me, you know, because I put a lot of work into making my music and like just in like everything, like the growth of myself, you know, my artistry, like I put a lot of work into that. So to see people like still show me love, man, it's just a blessing. I can't put words together to really like explain it to you, you know. It's just a blessing, man. Big blessing.
You've hit so many milestones in this past year. Mm. What has the highlight been though? What was the moment that felt like things had really shifted?
Every day feels new, man. Every day just feels like it just never stops. Never stops. I can't really place it and say this was the moment, because in a couple of days I'm going into the O2, like that's another moment. So it's like every day is just crazy for me, man. I'm very thankful though, very, very grateful, you know.
So in a single calendar year, you've had a Grammy with Beyonce, a huge remix with Bieber. Last year, did you imagine this year would be like this? Did you have any idea that this was around the corner?
Yeah, I felt it coming. I would say I'm lying if I didn't feel it coming, you know, because like it took me 3 years to work on that album, you know. So it's like I felt like there was gonna be a shift, but I didn't know like how it would come, you know, because like I knew that it was kind of like a different. It wasn't a different sound, but it was a more matured sound from what I used to make. So like I was like, yeah, I felt there was gonna be something, but you know, you can't, we're all human beings, you don't see the future now. So when it happens, it's just a blessing, and it's like, wow, you know.
Did you manifest this?
Yeah, of course.
In some way,
man.
Like, do you give yourself those affirmations?
Every time, from when I was like way young, man. Like, this is like, I called my first album Superstar. Like, how confident can you be? You know, so yeah, like, I was born to do this shit, man. Yeah.
When you look back at Don't Dull Wizkid, like 2010, 2011, and you look at yourself now, after the year you've just had, how different is this man?
Different, man. Yeah, really different. I got more kids now. You know,
had a couple kids in that time.
Yeah.
What we at now, three?
We at three right now. You
so
know,
far.
I love my boys, man. You know, they're like, they're a big blessing to my life, you know? They changed me, like, they made me a better person, so definitely, like, that has actually been the biggest change in my life, because, like, when I made Dundo, I had no kids, man. I was just running around, like, you know, wild boy. And 21, I had my first child, and I just had to, like, get to it. So, like, I'm very thankful for my kids, because that they put my head right, you know?
Yeah. Your circumstances have changed so much, mm-hmm, in the past year. Have you changed as a person in response to that?
Yeah.
Because it must be hard not to.
Yeah, you have to, man. You have to, like, you know, keep moving in life and just keep taking every day as it comes. And, you know, I don't really think much of anything, to be honest, you know. I just wake up, man, and just go with the flow, like, you know, like, yo, yeah, we have that, thank God, you know. Nah, that's how I am with life.
Do you feel that you can really sense that change that has occurred since, if we say last October, Made in Lagos, to now, more than a year later?
Yeah.
Can you really feel that you're a different person?
Of course.
In what way?
Just in my personal life, you know, my personal life, even like with the way that I make music, because like when I put out that album, I remember I had a conversation with P2J, like, you know, we made the album, like 90% of the album together. Crazy guy. And like, he was like, oh bro, I'm not really sure, you know, I'm nervous, I'm not really sure if the people are gonna love the song. I'm like, you're right, this is good music, like they're gonna fucking love it. Like, you don't even have to think about that. So it's like, after like putting that out and seeing like, okay, yeah, people really like love good music, so like, it just just helps you get better and better at what you do. So, yeah, I feel the change and difference every day, man.
Are you less accessible now?
I'm an introvert, man. I like to stay indoors. I don't like to do a lot of things. I like to go to a lot of parties. I don't hang out. Like,
really?
I used to love a lot of shit, but like, shit.
Has that come with the growth in attention and just?
No. I think that has really come from like just age and my personal experiences. You know. I think that's where that comes from. That's not like really about like how people perceive me. It's just like I'm growing older as each day passes. So like, yeah, getting smarter with my decisions, you know. You just know what you want more as you go older. Like, I don't want to be at the parties, you know. I don't like to hang around too many people. Like, when I go to the party sometime, I'm there. I'm excited to be there. And someone just spills a drink on me and I'll be like, I could be at home with my son, just, you know, just having a great time. I'm not liking, like, in any way. I don't feel insulted or anything.
Like,
I don't feel,
AK,
you know, I don't feel insulted or anything. But I just be like, well, I could just be home right now, like, having fun with my child, you know, like, yeah, so it's just different.
Has your phone number changed in the past year, though, right, surely?
The crazy thing is, if you want to hear the truth, I've used the same number for the last 8 years.
What? You still got the Ojo Elegba number now?
I got it.
I would have changed the number then. Brown skin girl, no, new number again. And it's the same number.
Same number, man. I recently just got another phone, like, just like a couple weeks ago.
You about to block some people in that time, surely?
Not really, you know. Like, I do. I'm not going to lie. I do. If I've had the same number for 8 years, trust me, I've done a lot of blocking on my phone. And not a lot of people have my number too, so that's why I can keep it, you know.
Has your creative process changed in the past year as well? After creating an album like that?
Definitely.
Do you change how you approach making the next thing?
I don't really change how I approach making the next thing. I just like I'm more comfortable with my sound now, you know, like it's like, yeah, it doesn't change, man. It's still the same process as I say. If it's not broken, they'll fix it, right? So I just do the same shit.
when you create a monster like Essence, though, mm-hmm. do you go back in the studio with just a different posture, a different energy to try and outdo that?
Crazy thing is, the night we made Essence, I made Gyrate the same night. So like sometimes in a night I make like 2 bangers, 3 bangers. So it's like I wake up and get to it. I treat this shit like school. Like I wake up in the morning and I'm like, yeah, I did well yesterday. Let's go. What are we doing today? You know what I mean? So
Gyrate and Essence in the same night.
Yeah.
Wow.
I make so many songs in the same, like I made Soko No and one other song in the same night.
Do you know what's great? I spoke to Tems a few months ago, mm-hmm. and she said to me when she recorded her part for Essence, she said she wanted to do it again.
Yeah.
She said she wasn't even sure.
Yeah, I know.
If that was the take. Sure. When you created Essence, did you know?
Of course.
That it was about to be what it was.
Yeah, hell yeah, man. I knew that was a smash. The night we made it, I actually tweeted something. Like, my fans actually was the one that reminded me of it after we put out the album.
What did you say?
Because I tweeted, like, me and Tems made magic. Tems and I made magic. That was what I tweeted. I'm like, I knew it was magic, man. I've been making this shit for 10 years. Come on, you think I'm not going to know if we make it?
Let's talk about Essence, because I don't know if I can recall another time. I don't think there has been another time when a song from the African continent has been so culturally and commercially well received. Like, to achieve both things simultaneously is huge. Of course, you broke records with the Billboard charts. What does that feel like in the moment when you've got a smash that just isn't slowing down?
Feels good, you know. I would lie to say that. Feel good. It feels great. Like, it feels really, really great. Like, when you have a record like that, it feels good, man. You know. But the most important thing is, when we made it, we wasn't thinking about no commercial success or anything like that. We was just trying to make good music, you know. So I think maybe that's why people really like that record like that, because it's like just comes from the soul, just natural, organic shit.
It's a song that just shifted. Everything. I don't think I've been out in a club since and not heard it. And it's an there's the obligation to sing along. It's that kind of song now. It's like national anthem. Okay, we got to sing Essence. Do you know what I mean? Like that, that is huge. But to then have that moment where it becomes the first song out of Nigeria to smash the top 10 on the Billboard charts. What is that like, being the first person to walk through such a big door? That's a huge door and you're the first through it.
I don't see it like that, you know. I don't think I'm the first through it. Like, I feel like I just, I don't know what I did, but I just kicked the door open. I feel like everyone's about to come through right now. There's about to be loads of records from Africa. That feels good, because the truth is, people are tired of listening to the same shit, you know, like on some real shit. And like during the pandemic, it kind of helped, because we're all in the house, so it helped everyone find, well, for me, basically, I would say speak for myself. Like, it made me understand the kind of music that I really loved to listen to more. Like, you know, so I feel like that just helped everyone get in touch with, like, oh yeah, man, I want to listen to some good music. What feels great? So when that record dropped, I feel it did the same thing. What it did for me was what it did for the people. Like, it made me like feel better every time I listen to the song. So it's just a great record, man. Great record. And I love Tems to death. She's like a special, special talent.
Incredible,
like,
talent.
She's like my top three.
Oh, without a doubt. I'm obsessed with Tems. Don't even get me started.
Nah, don't get me started.
We can turn this into Tems appreciation.
I
love Tems. From the moment, I think the first song I heard was, yeah, was Try Me, and I was like, whoa.
That was the first time I heard her too, and I remember like when I heard her, like, cause I'm like, I'm cool with her manager, right? So it's been my boy for a minute. So I was like, yo, I asked my boys when I got back to Lagos that, I'm like, who made this record? And I'm like, oh, Tems. I'm like, oh yeah. Our homeboy manages, and I'm like, oh yeah, call him and pull up. And I remember I brought her out for my show, like just immediately. I was like, yo, you're coming out for my concert to do Try Me.
You know?
So like, I've always been a fan, man. Like, I love to just see amazing talents, like, just get their own shine, get their own time. Like, Africa has a whole lot of that. There's so many amazing talents that's about to come through right now, you know? And I can't wait. I'm excited, trust me.
let's talk about Nigeria, because there have been a lot of eyes on Nigeria for the past year in terms of cultural influence, in terms of political climate with the NSARS movement. What is that like, being such a key figure from a country that so many eyes have been on? Because does it feel like there's a responsibility?
I don't feel like that, you know? Like, I don't really see life like that, you know? Like, I see life a little bit more simpler than that. We're all here to play a special role, you know? There's nobody special than the other. I don't see it like that. So it's like, yeah, I'm just doing what I have to do, you know? That's how I really see life. That's really my honest opinion.
What have you learned about yourself in this past year?
Yeah, I've actually learned to love a little bit more, you know? Love myself a little bit more, actually. Yeah, because it's like, I have a lot of love to give, you know? Like, I'm a people's person. Like, I'm like the guy that, like, I love everybody, you know? I want everyone to shine, I want everyone to win, you know? So this past year as well just made me, like, you know, spread that love within myself as well. So, yeah. I'm loving it.
What do you do for self-care? What have you been doing in this past 12 months, man, to show yourself some love?
I'm always watching Nollywood, man. That's
okay,
my favorite.
So
that's
Beyonce
my favorite
versus
thing.
Rihanna. Okay.
That's my favorite thing to watch, you know. And I just, that's zero self-care for me. Yeah. I have a room in my house. It's the hottest room in the whole house, like, because I keep it like warm. That's my little temple. So I'm just there relaxing and watching.
Has the house changed in the past year? It's big.
Changed before the past year.
Oh,
yeah.
It's big, isn't it?
Yeah, couple.
Yesterday's price is not today's price.
It's never.
Never.
It's never ever can be. When I leave here, the price is double. Africa, this, yeah.
How did you congratulate yourself after the year that you had?
Oof.
What did you do to
what
say,
did
you
I
know
do?
What, Wizzy? You had a good year.
What did I do? Yeah. I took my mom and my dad, like, I'm just like, you know what? I want you guys to enjoy yourself for the next 2 years. Just enjoy. Like, they was in Dubai for a month. That's my joy, man.
I love that. What I also love is your joy is Wizkid FC. Your day ones.
Yeah.
A fan base unlike any other.
Yeah.
They come out in force.
Madness.
Have you noticed a shift in those day one fans in this past year? Yeah. as your superstar has grown?
Yeah, it's getting scarier by the day, you know. And it's like, it's love. Like, I can't. I think that actually keeps me going too. Just knowing that, oh yeah, I have I don't even call them fans. I feel like my friends, you know, that connect to my music and like we are on this journey together. Like, that's how I see it. Yeah, and I'm very, very thankful for my fans, man. Very thankful.
The thing that I love about Wizkid FC is when they gatekeep against the new fans.
They do that.
And they're like, you wasn't there for Don't Go.
Yeah, they call them Essence fans. No?
Yeah, the Essence Warriors. Do you approach music with your day ones in mind? Do you still try to make music for them?
Yeah, of course, man. I don't think about like there's two type of fans, you know. Everyone is in one. I just feel like some people are catching late than the other people, but it's just it's the same kind of process for me when I make music. I don't try to cater for a couple people or sound or a market or like, oh yeah, I'm trying to cater for this mic. No. I just make the music, you know.
Now, as you approach the end of what has been an incredible year, what would you go back and tell Wizkid last year in preparation for the year that came?
I don't think I would have been able to tell him anything that would have prepared me enough, because I remember when I was like going through my tour in America, like I was looking at the dates. I'm like, oh yeah, you have 4 or 5 days like back to back. And I'm like, yeah, cool, I can do that. Yeah, maybe I would have gone back to say, yeah, you probably would have needed some more time in between the shows. Yeah, but that's probably what I would have told myself then. But
put some breaks. Yeah, put in
like
the,
some few days of like break. Yeah, but it was a great experience. I'm not even going to lie. Like, we had an amazing time in America. Like, we did like 2019 dates. Like,
incredible.
Every night sold out. Amazing.
Artist of the Year, Africa, on the Apple Music Awards, truly deserved. Where do you go from here next year?
Coming back to City again.
I like that talk. Back to back years.
Next album's ready. More Love, Less Ego.
Next album's ready. So when do you have time?
I was on tour recording. Like, I had a studio on the road with me.
Wow. Features, no features?
Few features. Three features. Just three features.
A lot of features are a mad thing.
Yeah, amazing stuff, man.
Because the demand for you must have noticed as well that the demand and the kind of people that want to be in your presence has changed. Was there a moment where you were like, wow, with somebody that tried to reach out to you?
The crazy thing is, you want to hear the joke? Not really. I've been doing this for 10 years of my life, like more than 10 years of my life, you know. Like, I've been in the room with so many people, like I've met so many people, and I'm so quiet, like, you know, I don't really put my personal life out there. I just put like my work, go on my Instagram, it's just work. Like, I don't, you know, I try to keep that, you know. So it's like, I don't think there's really, it's just more respect, I would say, you know, because now people are like, oh yeah, they get it. Why I'm a nutter, like, why I don't pay attention to, why I don't like going out, why I'm like in my own zone, like they get it now, like, you know what I mean? Mm. Yeah, I think that's it.
The original star boy.
Yeah.
The only star boy.
Only star boy. I don't know about you, that star boy. Just star
Wiz,
boy.
Congratulations, well deserved. Apple Music 2021 Artist of the Year, Africa.
Thank you, man. Big blessings to God and the fans, you know?